The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
I hope all are going well. Okay. In the previous class, we discussed the business environment, its features and dimensions of business environment. Isn't it? Which are the dimensions of business environment? That is, economic environment, social environment, political environment, legal environment and technological environment. Okay. I hope all are clear. Today we are going to discuss about the topic economic environment in India. Economic environment in India. See, economic environment is the most important dimension of business environment. So, the various economic factors which have impact on business firm. Which are the economic factors influence the business firm? That is the first one, economic structure. We know that Indian economy is a mixed economy, isn't it? What is mixed economy? That means the economy shows both capitalist and socialist features. Such types of economy is known as mixed economy. So, the business policies are taken by considering both profit and welfare of people. That is the first one, economic structure. That is first one, economic structure. Second economic factors is economic planning. So, it includes what? Annual budget, 5-year plans, NITI Aayog, that is National Institution for Transforming India. So, these plans also influence the business decision. That is the second one, economic planning. And the third one, economic policies. Economic policies. So, that the economic policies also influence the business environment. Which are the economic policies? That is the physical policy, industrial policy, monetary policies, etc. So, in 1991, July, Indian government declared a new industrial policy which sought to liberate the Indian industry from licensing system, significantly reduce the role of public sector, and encourage what? Foreign participation in industrial development. So, the liberal policies offer more opportunities to businessmen, whereas strict policies put constraint. That is the second or third one. That is the third one, economic policy. And the next factor, economic factor, is economic indicators. The economic indicators include GDP, per capita income, national income, value of export and import, balance of payment, GNP, etc. are the economic indicators. These indicators also influence the business firm. And the last one, what is it? Infrastructure. So, what is it? Infrastructure, that is basic facilities. So, the infrastructure refers to the basic services or facilities necessary to carry on business activities in a country, that is financial institution, banking infrastructure, communication facilities, transport system, etc. The infrastructure. These are the important economic factors which influence the business firm. Which are the first one? What is it? First one, economic structure. Second one, economic planning. Third one, economic policies. Fourth one, economic indicators. Fifth one, infrastructure. Okay. Next topic, economic environment of India since independence. Economic environment of India since independence. So we know that there has been tremendous changes in Indian economic environment since independence. So at the time of independence, agricultural sector was dominated in our country, in our economy. Around 85% of population was lived in village. So almost a 3/4 of total population was occupied in an agricultural sector. Okay. And business firms were used outdated technology in their production. And the lack of adequate infrastructure facilities like what? Road, banking, telecommunication, etc. And then immediately after independence, in order to solve the economic problem, government of India made some plans and policies. So these plans and policies were giving importance to public sector. So many areas like what, telecom, insurance, railway, airway, etc. were reserved only for public sector and limit the role of private sector. Okay. After independence, during the first 3-5 year plans, the growth objective received greater attention, and there was a rapid expansion of public sector. Later on the poor performance of public sector was realized. So what is the reason for the poor performance of public sector? That is unorganized clients, outdated technology, underutilization of capacity, trade unionism, political interference, inefficient inventory control are the main and poor personal policies, etc. are the reason for poor performance of public sector. So, the poor performance of public sector forced the government to do rethinking on public enterprise. And the industrial policy 1991 seeks to restrict the role of public sector. So, the features of new industrial policy in 1991, that is the year 1991, made turning point in India's economic history. That is, a major shift in industrial policy was made by government of India, led by Mr. P.V. Narasimha Rao on July 24, 1991. So, the policy has sought comprehensive changes in economic regulation in the country. As a part of the policy, the role of public sector has been redefined. Public sectors in the role of redefined. So, a dedicated reform policy for the public sector, including the disinvestment program, was launched under new industrial policy 1991. So that means the private sector has welcomed in the major industries that were previously reserved for the public sector. Okay. Other than new industrial policy 1991 pragaram, the public sectors in the role കൂടുതൽ പാർട്ടിസിപ്പേഷൻ ആർക്ക് കൊടുക്കാനാണ് ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻസ് കൊടുക്കുന്നത്? പ്രൈവറ്റ് സെക്ടേഴ്സിന് കൊടുക്കുന്നത്. but the most important reform measures of Indian industrial policy was it ended the practice of industrial licensing. Industrial കൊടുക്കുന്ന ലൈസൻസ് എന്ത് ചെയ്തു എന്നാണ് പറയുന്നത്, അവസാനിപ്പിച്ചു എന്നുള്ളതാണ് ഈ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ ന്യൂ ഇന്ത്യ ന്യൂ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ പോളിസിയുടെ ഏറ്റവും ശ്രേഷ്ഠമായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു റിഫോംസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. സോ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ ലൈസൻസിങ് റെപ്രസെന്റ് ഫോർ റെഡ് ടാക്സ്, ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ ലൈസൻസിങ് റെപ്രസെന്റഡ് ഫോർ ദ റെഡ് ടാക്സ്. സോ ദ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ പോളിസി brought changes in the various aspects of industrial regulations. Which are the aspects? That is the first one, abolition of industrial licensing. First one, what is it? Abolition of industrial licensing. That means in major move to liberalize the economy, the new industrial policy abolished all industrial license except for certain industries related to security and strategic concern and social reasons. അതായത് ചില ഈ 1991-ലെ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ പോളിസിയിൽ വന്നിട്ടുള്ള ഒന്നാമത്തെ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ചേഞ്ച് ലൈസൻസിങ് സമ്പ്രദായം എടുത്തുകളഞ്ഞെന്നാണ് പറയുന്നത്. അതായത് ചില മേഖലകളിൽ ഒഴിവേ, അതായത് ചില മേഖലകൾ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ സെക്യൂരിറ്റി ആൻഡ് സ്ട്രാറ്റജിക് കൺസേൺസും സോഷ്യൽ റീസൺസ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ചില കൺസേൺസ് ഒഴിവേ ബാക്കിയുള്ള ഇൻഡസ്ട്രീസിന് ലൈസൻസ് വേണ്ട എന്നുള്ളതാക്കി എന്നാണ് ഇതിൽ പറയുന്നത്. So the till 1991 seven industries were reserved for public sector. Okay, now there are only three industries for licensing is compulsory. For three industries ne license vendru adu edukena, that is these are atomic energy, arms and rail transport. That is the first one, abolition of industrial licensing. ലൈസൻസ് എന്ത് ചെയ്തു കൊടുക്ക, ലൈസൻസിങ് വേണം എന്നുള്ളത് ആ ഒരു ലൈസൻസ് വേണം എന്നുള്ളത് അബോളിഷ് ചെയ്തു. ദെൻ സെക്കൻഡ് വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഇറ്റ്, പബ്ലിക് സെക്ടർസ് റോൾ ഡൈലൂട്ടഡ്. വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഇറ്റ്, മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രീസ് റിസർവ് ഫോർ പബ്ലിക് സെക്ടർസ് അണ്ടർ ഏർലിയർ പോളിസി വേർ ദി റിസർവ്. സോ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയൽ പോളിസി 1991 സീക്സ് ടു റെസ്ട്രിക്ട് ദ റോൾ ഓഫ് public sector and open the door to private sector. Appo 1991 industrial policies public sectors ne role reduce cheyum private sectors ne role endu cheyu increase cheyana chenna. So the government identified as strategic and priority area for public sectors to concentrate. Similarly, laws making public sectors undertakings were sold to the private sector. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ എന്ത് സംഭവിച്ചു, നഷ്ടത്തിൽ പോയിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന പബ്ലിക് സെക്ടേഴ്സ് എന്റർപ്രൈസസിനെ ആർക്ക് സെയിൽ ചെയ്യുന്നു, പ്രൈവറ്റ് സെക്ടേഴ്സിനെ സെയിൽ ചെയ്യുകയും ചെയ്തു. അഡോപ്റ്റഡ് ഡിസ്ഇൻവെസ്റ്റ്മെന്റ് പോളിസി ഫോർ റീസ്ട്രക്ചറിംഗ് ഓഫ് ദി പബ്ലിക് സെക്ടർ ഇൻ ദി കൺട്രി. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് പബ്ലിക് സെക്ടർ റോൾ ഡൈലൂട്ടഡ്. And then third one, free entry to foreign investment and technology. So another major features of economic reform measure was it has given welcome to foreign investment and foreign technology. So these measures has enhanced the industrial competition and improve the business environment in the country. That is free entry to foreign investment and technology. And then last one, amendment of MRTP Act. So that means to take away restriction on investment by business firm under MRTP Act. Actually, these are the changes adopted under the industrial policy 1991. Which are the changes? That is, first one, abolition of industrial licensing. Second one, public sectors role diluted. Third one, free entry for foreign investment and technology. And the last one, what is it? Amendment of MRPP Act. And I hope all are clear. Next, we can discuss about the major changes or impact of economic policy 1991. That is, the industrial policies of 1991 is the big reform introduced in Indian economy since independence. The policy caused big changes, including emergence of a strong and competitive private sector and sizable number of foreign companies in India. The new policy contained policy direction for reform and thus for LPG. You heard about LPG. What is LPG? That is liberalization, privatization and globalization. That is the major changes of, that is the major impact of economic policy in 1991. That is LPG. What is it? Liberalization, privatization and globalization. So the branches of new economic policy we can categorize into three ways, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization. What is it? Liberalization? You heard about the liberalization. Liberalization means liberating economy from unnecessary control and regulation and making economy more competitive. So the 1991 policy introduced the following measures of liberalization. That is, the first one, abolition of industrial licensing except in a few. And then second one, that is liberalization in import and export. Liberalization the economy from unnecessary control. And then freedom in fixing price. And easy, next one, what is it? Easy and simplifying the procedures to attract foreign capital in India. And removal of what? Restriction on the movement of goods and services. Removal of restriction on the movement of goods and services. And the next one, what is it? The sixth one, what is it? Freedom in deciding the scale of business activities. And reduction, seventh one, what is it? Reduction in tax rate and removal of all unnecessary control over the economy. The important measures of liberalization. Okay, I hope all are clear. Okay, related to the major impact of new industrial policy 1991. So, if you have any doubt, please contact me.